Understanding lipids can seem difficult to apply. By definition, lipids are substances that do not dissolve in water. Some common examples of lipid classes are cholesterol and triglycerides. Cholesterol can either be made in our body or eaten in our foods. In our foods, cholesterol is only found in animal products. Meats, cheeses, eggs, butter, and other animal products can be high in cholesterol. I find it amusing when advertisers try to use this to their advantage when promoting their product. For example, a cracker can be made of only plant ingredients, and the manufacturer will try to get your attention by claiming that it's a cholesterol-free food. All fruits, vegetables, grains, legumes, and nuts are cholesterol-free foods by virtue of the fact they're plant products. Only living animals can produce cholesterol. An interesting fact about cholesterol is that it's been well documented that if you have a high fiber diet, it can decrease blood cholesterol. You may ask, how can eating fiber change cholesterol level in the body? The two seem unrelated, but fiber is an indigestible carbohydrate that binds to bile. Bile is made of cholesterol and is normally recycled. However, if we consume a high fiber diet, the fiber will bind the bile and pass out of the body and cannot be recycled. Then we will need to make more bile and pull cholesterol out of the blood to do so. The other major class of lipids we will discuss is the triglycerides. Keep in mind that we're not creative in the sciences. Triglycerides got their name because they contain three fatty acids and one glycerol, hence the name triglyceride. 95% of the lipids in our food are in the form of triglyceride. But on a label, we refer to all triglycerides as fat. Scientifically, referencing all triglycerides as fat is not completely accurate. In its most accurate definition, a fat is solid at room temperature. For example, butter and lard remain solid when sitting on a counter and are therefore fats. Triglycerides that are liquid at room temperature are referred to as oils. Corn oil, canola oil, and many other plant oils are liquid at room temperature and often sold in bottles. Both fats and oils have similar structures. As stated earlier, they're both triglycerides made from a glycerol backbone with three fatty acids attached. But it is the three fatty acids that determine whether it's solid at room temperature or a liquid. In general, the more saturated a fatty acid, the longer the chain, the more solid the triglyceride is at room temperature. The more unsaturated the fatty acid and the shorter the chain, the more liquid the triglyceride is at room temperature. When it comes to applying this information, it's suggested to avoid solid animal fats for better heart health. It's also recommended that individuals consume less than 30% of their calories from triglycerides or fat. Many people try to eat fruits and veggies because they're healthy and low in fat. However, I've seen people slice a nice, juicy, and low-fat apple and proceed to dip it in caramel dip. Or people steam heads of healthy broccoli and then drench them in processed cheese. Some even make a large, fresh green salad and drizzle excessive amounts of salad dressing high in saturated fat over the top. All these behaviors take a once healthy, low-fat food and drastically change the calorie and fat content by the dip or sauce. If you're trying to consume a lower fat diet, my challenge to you is to eat your fruits and veggies naked. Don't drizzle, dip, or fry them.